Hello, this is Pamela. Welcome to my channel. Grab you a cup of coffee, sit back and relax, and enjoy some good old yarny talk. Hello, this is Pamela, and you're on Pamela's Adoring Crochet. Welcome to my channel, and I would like to say thank you for everyone for coming back and watching my videos and leaving your comments. And if you are new to my channel, we are so glad to have you here. Today's video is really to kind of show off some happy mail of some yarn that I had ordered for a specific project that I would like to do. And then the other one is I have a finished object, and I guess in a way you could call it two. Okay, so grab you a cup of coffee, grab you some tea or something to drink, and let's go ahead and get started. I did show in my last video, I got my Crochet Society box. Well, here is what I have done with mine. And I put my stitch markers on here. And this is all the stitch markers I have. So I put them on here, and I'm going to hang this up. If I end up getting more over the years, I don't know really what I'm going to do. I'll probably buy me another one of these top, but bigger, because I really like it, and buy me some more of these push pins. And anyway, I think it's really cool. So I got this whole thing out of my Crochet Society, and it I had to put the little bracket on the back of it for it. So anyway, so I'm going probably to hang it up right there, or it may go over there. I'm not really sure. I know that I'm centered right in the middle, so I'm not really sure exactly where I'm going to hang it, but I finally will get to display the stitch markers that I do have. I do have one on here I wanted to show you that is my favorite. Here we go. Let's see. This right here has a little bicycle on it. Isn't it cute? This was from Derek, the Knitwick Strong, and he had, Yarn Hag Ryan was doing some heart attack boxes. And I won one of her heart attack boxes. And so he had two, actually. He had this one and I believe these glasses right here. So very appropriate for me as well. And so I happened to win that month, and that's what I got for my stitch markers. So that's very memorable. And I just recently received this from Lynette from Charm Grammy Crochet. Hi, Lynette. So I have hers on there as well. And then some of these are from Leather Company, My Fish, and the Cinderella. And then I have this one. And I'm sorry, I can't remember where I got the letters. But it was a gift. It's from a yarny friend. So thank you very much. And if you are the one who sent me those, because it's been a while, write in my comment box, hey, Pamela, I'm the one that sent those to you. And I will be sure to make sure that in my next video, I give you your proper shout out, because I do love those. They're so cool. They have the little letters on them. And, you know, I might have won it in a giveaway. I just can't remember. It's been a while. A lot has happened since last year. Okay, so moving on. Okay, I'm really excited to show this little booger off. I made one of these. Isn't it adorable? This is, here, look at that. I even made it crinkle on the inside. This is a very easy pattern, and of course, you know, I made it for my grandson to be, but I'm going to make a few more because there are, a few of my daughter's friends that are having babies this month and next month, and I think in April. And so some are girls and some are boys. So I've got to make several of these. So dig this. Okay, I got the pattern out of my newest Crochet World magazine. Guys, this worked up really quick. Let's see, I even have my, here it goes. It's nice to do a project that works out, isn't it, guys? And especially if it's, you know, a pretty quick project. How can I get, there it is. Okay, it's called
Baby Owl Teether. And it's by Lori Sanfratello. It says it's a number 3 easy. It takes medium 4-weight yarn, a K hook, which was nice because I got to work with a big hook. The little circles and things like that on it. I think they took a J hook, which was still a big hook. So here it is. And here is my version. Pretty much looks just like it. So I did really good. I did not want to use this. I wanted the gray for mine. So, I mean, I have that color, but I just wanted gray. And, yeah. So I'm going to make the blue one and the pink. Now, I think on this, I used that Craft Smart for my white from Michaels. And I don't have it in here, but these other colors I used from my Wee Crochet Brava. I just pulled out some little some 4-weight yarns and just, you know, kind of made that. So it's basically from scraps. This right here really can be from scraps. I pretty much followed the pattern. I did a few things on my own, but nothing big, nothing to have to really say, because you can follow it along pretty good. Because I can kind of see what it looks like. I kind of went by the directions and I'm like, okay, well, I can just finish that myself. So I did. All right. So let's see what else. Oh yeah. The little round things. I can't remember exactly what size I have, but I ordered these off Amazon earlier in the year and I got a whole bag of them. There they are. I think they may be 1.5. I don't have a tape measure here. Diameter. Anyway, so I've got plenty of those. I got a little bag of them. You know, I made one with the koala bear, and then you had the little round teether. And so, of course, when I saw this, I was super excited because I was like, something to do with all those rings I bought, because I only used one ring out of a big old package. So it came in really handy. Yeah. All right, so to tell you what I did to get this crinkle. All right. I took a mailing bag. You know how they got the little bubbles on one side? So I just cut it to fit. I just like laid my piece on it like this and then just cut me the shape that I need. And then I just, when you crochet, you're crocheting in the round. And so when you, but it has two openings, kind of like a tube. And then so when I closed up one end of it, then I just inserted my piece. This is after I already have my stuff. Do not put this together and then try to put this on. It will be so much easier on you if you put your face on and then close your top. Now, I did have my bottom closed. So after you get your face on there, then insert your piece in it, your crinkle piece. and then close it up and then, you know, add these little fringes and then add this to the bottom. So that's pretty much the construction of it. All right. So that's what I did with that, how I got that going. So I've got several more of these to make because there's some girls. So I've got some pink yarns pulled out and stuff, you know, because I got to make some more. When I was at my local Walmart, I found me some brown buttons to go on a couple of my everyday cardigans that I've been making lately. So there's my buttons. Got that taken care of. I finally was able to get to Walmart. You know, I had not left my house from Sunday of last week to Saturday. Sunday of last week to this Sunday of this week. And then Sunday after church, this Sunday, even this Sunday, I just went to church and then came straight home. So Monday, I actually got out. So technically, I really hadn't been anywhere but to church on one Sunday to the next Sunday and was home the entire week. But our trash has not run. Our mail has not run. We got our first mail Saturday. And then Sunday, you know, the next day, no mail. Still have not received any of my Ipsy and Knit Crate and things like that. But I did receive this yesterday. And so I'm really excited about this one. And they don't put the prices on here, but I'm pretty sure that my price was, and I did pay shipping and handling, which is like maybe $8.95, I think. something like that. But I'm pretty sure it was under $25 for this yarn. That's with shipping and handling and tax, I think. But I'll let you know in another video, or if I can look it up, if I can find the email, if I hadn't deleted it already, when I do this video, I'll just leave it down the bottom, okay? But what I've got was this, I think this was like $3 and something. This, like, I really need another project bag, you know? But I want to support yarnnut.com. And Gia is the owner of it, and I like supporting her. She's really nice. She will go out of your way to help you. If you have not ordered yarn or any accessories or anything from her website, please go check her out. Gia will go out of her way to make sure that if your order is not right, she will make it right. So she's a very sweet lady. But anyway, it's just a, you know, plastic bag. Oh, I didn't see, notice that on the inside. Hold on. Craft something great today. Let's get that open. Look at that. Craft something great today. But I really like it. It was like $3.18. And so I was like, well, I'm just going to throw that in there. Well, here is the yarn that I ordered. And then I'll show you the project that I would like to do. I don't know. It may be a little hard for me. And if it is, oh well, I'll just use the yarn for something else. I have not even got to feel this yarn yet. Ooh, it does feel good. This is different. I'll tell you that. Made in Turkey. 4 medium weight. Lorena worsted. Here it is. And where's my thing again? It says candy pink is the color. And so I ordered 3 of these. And for this one, it's the color says beige. Let me see if I can tell you how many yards are in it. It's like, it's not like baby soft, but it is soft, but it has a real coolness feel to it. Kind of reminds me of shoestrings. But here's the 2 colors that I ordered. So candy pink and beige are the 2 colors. Let's see if it says it's 35% cotton, 45% acrylic. Let's see. It says Lorena worsted ash yarns. I was going to see if it tells me how many yards are in this thing. Made in Turkey. Okay, so let's go on. Here's what I want to make, and I will leave a picture of it in color because my printer is black and white. So let's see if I have a better picture real quick. Okay, that may be the only picture I have. But that's okay. This is what I would like to make. And that is in blue and the beige. And this is the yarn that they called for. And so I was like, oh, I know where I can get that yarn locally. Well, in the States. And so I was pretty excited when I had come across this pattern and got to look to see what kind of yarn that it called for. And I saw that it was ice yarn. So I immediately went to yarnnut.com and to see if they had this yarn. And they did. I will leave, like I said, I'll leave a picture so that you can see this in color. Now, I don't know if how hard this is going to be for me to do. I don't know. But I am going to try it. I'm not going to let it pass. I mean, it's something that I want. Obviously, I ordered all this yarn for it. If it does not come out and I can't understand it, I will find something else to do with my yarn. You guys know that, right? But I am going to try my best and make that little bag. So I just thought it was really cute. Here's a picture of it, like with the handles down. So, all right, so where you can find this, it's called All-Time Favorite Tote Bag, crochet4ublog.com. And the 4 is spelled out F-O-R. It's not the letter, the number 4. It's spelled out. So it's crochet4ublog.com. And I will leave the link in the description box. And if anybody wants to make this with me, it'll be fun. I'd like to see all the different you know, ways that or colors that people choose to make theirs. So if you go there, this is like really thick, but it's because the way my printer printed it out. I mean, see, I got half, it's like half my instructions are on one side and then this is blank. So technically my instructions shouldn't be this, this thick. I'm like, when I first pulled this out after printing it, I printed it first and ordered my yarn. And then while I was waiting for the yarn to come in, I went in there and got it off my printer. And then I was like, oh, you know, because a few days had passed by. And I was like, oh my gosh, that's really thick. That's going to take forever to make. And then I got to looking at it and one side of the page is empty. So, see, so it's not, hopefully it's not going to be as bad as what that right there looks. I don't know if you guys are like that, but if it's really a lot of papers, I don't know. I'm like, that might be a little too much. Okay, so I hope you guys have enjoyed this. And if you want to make this bag with me, I think it'd be fun. And we can all learn something new. I have no idea how to make it. I have not even read row one yet. I just know I saw it, I liked it, and I knew I could go to yarnnut.com and order the yarn. So thank you, Gia, for having this yarn in stock. And I was able to make it, or able to get the yarn so that I can make this project. Okay, let's go ahead and do our 365 days of prayer. Let's see where we are at today. Who can criticize? Keep a good conscience so that in the thing in which you are slandered, those who rival your good behavior in Christ will be put to shame. 1 Peter 3:16. God, who can know you and criticize you? You are perfect and all your ways are wonderful. Those who don't know you may think they have something to say and they may criticize me for my devotion to you. Let them talk. When I consider my life before you or imagine my life without you, all I see is emptiness. People who resent my hope, envy my peace, or misunderstand your goodness can say what they want. With your help, I'll live a life that gives them nothing new to add to their complaint. In fact, your light in me may just change their minds. Let it be so, Lord. Do you realize that God's light in you can change people's minds about you and Him? It's very nice. Okay, I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. I feel like I didn't have too much to offer you guys. But if I did, I'm really glad. Okay, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe.